just pretend that I'm a guard here, and beautiful night, nothing's gone wrong. I'm gonna go back up to my post, just doo-doo-doo, on the way up, pretend I'm a guard. Gonna go to bed, take one last look around, everything's good over there. The town is sleeping quietly, and down that way. Ah! What's up, everybody? How is everyone? I am great. Thank you for asking. We should start doing episodes like Dora the Explorer style, where I like ask you questions, I respond back. Like it worked for Dora. I don't see any difference how it won't work for me. I've made some changes to this little stairway. We were talking about how it was really hard to see it actually going up. Well, it's still hard to see even though I added these pillars. I'm not even sure that I like them. But for now, I kind of want to just say, whatever. The tower looks pretty sweet. Oh gosh, the tower looks pretty sweet. Hello, everybody. Hello to the new people. We got a shout out. Yeah, we got a shout out from Combat Keen. Thank you, my brother. That actually got us over 200 subs. And, you know, I haven't been putting a whole lot. By the way, I'm waiting for cobble to smelt. And I just figured that we'd talk while I did it and enjoy the new view. I really love the view of this tower. I just love it. What was I saying? Oh, yeah. We've been growing. Like my aim is to get consistent growth every single day. And I haven't really been putting up a whole lot of videos, which a lot of you have probably noticed. I've just been pretty busy, but I'm actually going to have a lot more free time pretty soon to make more videos. But the fact that we've been growing consistently, even without the videos, is a pretty good sign that when we put out some awesome content that the success will follow. Not that I'm just here for success, but, you know, it's motivation. Anyways, I do have a project today. I'm going to just... We've got plenty of stone for now. I can come back if I need it. We talked about how I wanted to make this series more story-driven, how our kind of what we build is decided by a story. So we're kind of like creating our own universe here. I have my fog turned way up. I kind of like it when I'm like looking up here, but now I'm looking down at the town and I can't even see most of the town. So we built this tower. I'm actually gonna change the fog. Turn it all the way up for now. So I put some rooms in here, by the way. It's not like super detailed out. Like this floor is pretty boring. This floor is like a little more interesting. This one's like where it's at though. And this is like it's a watchtower, right? So like there's like, so this is like a one person guards barrack. They can watch over the town here and see from that direction and see this direction. And they can see in this direction. If we actually turn fog off, how do you turn it off? Fog off. And actually turn up our render distance. And look this direction. Yeah, there we go. There's actually a mountain over there. And I was thinking, you can't see anything over this hill. And you certainly wouldn't see any. So yeah, I don't know why I tried to add on to that. Words are very hard for me today. I spent like 4 days studying and nothing else, just studying. We can't see over these hills, so it makes sense to me that you would have a second watchtower over here, maybe not even as big of one. So that's like the main watchtower, and over here you would maybe have a secondary tower. And it would be on this mountain, I think. And I scouted out this mountain. And I don't want this to be just any watchtower, by the way. And you'll see what I mean once we get up here and build it. So this is where it's going to be. And you can see, you know, all the way over there. You can see all the way over here. And I don't have my render distance turned up super long way. But, you know, I can pretty much see everything over here. Only thing that we can't really see is on this side. And the reason I didn't, I thought about putting the tower over here, but I think it's important that the towers need to signal each other. So I'm thinking like Lord of the Rings, where they have like these, they're kind of like structures shaped like gables, or not gables. You know those little things with just roofs that they put next to ponds, whatever they're called. I'm like blanking out so hard on what they're called. Oh, hello. I thought you were just stone. I'll take you. Where is my dirt? I hate when the select tool doesn't work. Anyways, they need, like, in the movies, they, like, have a way to warn each other, and that's, like, lighting their big thing of fire, right? If we had, gosh dang it, this shovel's way too good. If we had one over there, it wouldn't be able to see this tower, and there would be no signaling to be had unless the tower was, like, really tall. And I just think it makes more sense to build a tower over here and maybe have a little watch station over there. And then it could clearly warn this tower here. But what is it warning it of? That's kind of where we're going here. Now, I already said that I want to make this more story-driven. Well, let's give it a story. Let's give it a story, all right. There's going to be something that the watchtower is warning us against, and I'm not going to go into that yet. It's going to be a little bit of a mystery, I think. Let's actually fill this in a little bit and make some room. I think I'm going to place... I want to just get the snow. Yeah. Ugh. This is tough. This is too tough. Building... Minecraft is tough. See, I can't even place dirt. So, these ruins... There goes the surprise. This tower is going to be somewhat in ruins. I'm going to keep it in theme with that one. The tower itself, we don't really need to flesh out its design because it's not going to be entirely there, right? Like, it's going to be destroyed partially. So it doesn't need to be a great design. What needs to stick out is that it's a tower and that it's in some way been attacked. And who's attacked it? What's attacked it? Gonna leave that for another day. I know the answer, but you don't. But you will. You will. So let's start right here and just start with the same size base that we had. And I think we did 3x3 with wood like this. Do I have... Okay, let's turn these. This is how... For those of you that think that I'm such a great builder, and you want to know how I do the things that I do. Well, you make stupid mistakes like this, and then you say, Do I have any stone? Those are the things that cross my mind when I'm building. Oh, gosh, I'm so bad at this. The nice thing about actually decorating the interiors of all the buildings that you do, which I have a hard time actually finishing, but it gives you a place to sleep when you're off away from your normal spawn, if you only have one spawn, so I don't have to go all the way back to town.
This knife has a straight edge on it, so it's very easy. Maybe in our world here, there live a happy little mountain.
Fuego! Yeah, this is, I know you can't see much of it, this is the top of it, and so far, I've made it very, easy to fall off of, no, very ambiguous, like, the overall shape, there's, like, remnants of structures that you're, like, you know were something, but you don't know, maybe you don't know exactly what it was. So I'll give you an example. There's these pillars here. I'm actually going to place something on top of it. There's these pillars here that look like they maybe supported a roof at some point above this fire. But, you know, you can't really tell what it looked like or what it was supposed to look like. Like I said, very ambiguous. And it's not done yet. I want one side to be more broken down than the other. In particular, this side. And I want it to be slightly visible from this angle. But I want it to be like, well, you should be able to see the lit fire from there. And you should be able to... I'm going to tuck this in, this wall in at that level. I want you to be able to tell that it's somewhat broken down and that it's on fire. So since it's during nighttime, this is a great time to look at it. Let's actually turn on shaders. Video shaders. Let's actually go to medium. I don't get as good of frame rates as I'd like with medium shaders, but we're just going to be keeping on for a moment here. So it's not going to be too bad. Yeah, hello, I can't see anything, especially because I have my render distance up a little ways. The good news is that I'm pretty close to being able to get a new gaming rig that could handle this kind of stuff all the time if I wanted to. I had the money for it. That looks cool. I want to wait till it's nighttime. I had the money for it. I'm just kind of waiting a little bit so that I don't have to be broke after buying it. That's cool. Ooh, that is super bright. It lights up the banners and they glow. Like, they glow. You can see the bridge from here. Kind of wish that lit up more, like the bottom of it. That doesn't make much sense, though. This isn't like some magic community or something. So let's go up here. And one more. I always forget how many it is. And we should be able to see... Okay, so the fire is clearly visible. I think I might want to expand that roof just a little bit. Like, I have that slab on top. It kind of shows that that was supporting something. But I'm not sure. We can ruin it a little bit more than it is. Although I wish it was brighter. The moon's right over it. Does that make a difference? Because it looks awfully bright over there. Let's just, for the sake of it, time set. I think 20,000 should be later on in the night. Yeah. So it is darker over there now. It's alright. I was hoping that would glow more. I bet if we put more structure around it, then it'll glow more. So it's a good thing that we checked that out. You can actually see it when you're sleeping. That's a great spot. I didn't even plan it, but that's a great spot. You don't even have to leave bed to keep an eye on that watchtower. What a beautiful view of all the monsters. I wonder if I can snipe some from here. They're probably all going to disappear. There's plenty of creepers, though. I have not used a bow in so long. I just avoid night. There's a group of three right here. It's kind of hard to miss them once you get it in that area. As I miss them. It's interesting to me that some of these are one shot, some of them are not. I wonder if I didn't have the bow fully charged. There should be lots of gunpowder for me to pick up down here. Why are there so many chickens gathering in here? All right, I've gotten my walls more or less where I want them to be. Remember how I said this place was kind of hard to stay on? Yeah, I can't even get on it. Okay, let's break that. So this is obviously where most of the damage was. Now, I wanted to make it look like there's like rubble. So the inside, very easy, just like that. Looks like there's rubble. Right, like obviously it got hit by something right there, and then the wall collapsed in right there. Simple enough. We can even make it look like, well, I don't know how floors would work in here. I'm not too worried about the floors right now. I do want to light it though, so that we can prevent the chickens from dying to zombies that keep laying eggs. Where'd my chickens go? Oh. Why do I always press record? I need to start checking the freaking daytime. Oh well. And then I think it's safe to say, let's get some gravel. Like this, like just gravel in general in this area. And get that cobble back. Like so. Should I just stay out here? I really don't want to, but I'll do it. Don't doubt me. So there's, I want more slabs. Like putting a random slab to me looks messier. Like a pile of stuff, right? Like that's a pile of rocks to me. So it clearly got hit by something right there. It's nighttime again. Let's see what it looks like now with shaders from over there. Yeah, it looks like something went wrong there. Something else that I could maybe do is add more fire other than just the tower. I kind of wanted to like, so where I have that little lip, sorry, if you can hear me moving around my chair, sorry, okay? I kind of wanted to add fire like on that little lip, but that would catch the wood on fire. So maybe fire around it. We can make the whole thing look more like a battlefield than it does, I suppose. Let's do it. Uh-huh. See, I like that. Need more. Maybe right here, as long as the nether rack is hidden. Oh, ow. Okay. As long as the nether rack is hidden, we could even do some down here. There's no trees around here, are there? No. So yeah, that's clearly a bad spot. Like, I don't think that this will set any wood on fire. Actually, it might. I guess we'll find out. And I've set one over here, which you'll be able to see over there. And we can even do one over here, just because. Like, I think that... Ooh, you wouldn't be able to see that from with this tree. I'm going to tear down this tree, actually. I feel like it's... Sometimes it's good to have, like, structures blocking structures. It kind of, like, piques your interest. But that's what the fire is doing. It piques your interest in the way that you can't see something, so you want to get a different look at a different view on it. That tree doesn't help. This fire is doing what I want that to do. So we can close this, and let's actually just touch this whole building up for a second. I kind of don't like this being just a flat arc, so, not arc, but indent. Sometimes I just say words, and I have no idea where I get them from. So it doesn't really matter so much on this side. Because that's not what's drawing your attention, I guess. Especially not there. Because I have it there as rubble. But that's pretty good. Now, this isn't by any means, like... The building itself isn't the good detail here. And that's kind of what I was experimenting with. To see if I could make what would otherwise be a pretty ugly building look good. Without, you know, just from it being in ruins. I think it looks alright. It's not my most favorite. Like, this would definitely be an ugly building if it wasn't in ruins. It's definitely interesting from over here, I bet. Viewing from over here, which, like I said, we could have some kind of viewing platform over here. You definitely see that it's in ruins. Now, that's a good view. That makes it look good. Now... I wanted to make... it could help if this was over here. But the thing is, this came from somewhere, and that's important. If it was a hole on this side, that would imply that it came from like over here if it's a projectile. But that would defeat the purpose of this tower, right? Like the tower's purpose is that it's detecting things over here that this tower cannot. Oh, you know what would be a really cool thing? Be right back. All right, check this out. Now look over here. What's a distinguishing factor or like a distinguished feature of this tower? It's that flag, right? Like that flag, the roof. Well, we don't have a hay roof. That won't make much sense here because fire. That's why I made it a stone roof. But that flag could be... It could be like in ruins, like or like falling down somewhere. So we could have it like, we could have it draped over the edge, but that would catch on fire. Or we could just have it kind of on the ground, right? So something like this, and it doesn't need to look great either. So let's actually that can stay. The snow can stay. I kind of want to do something like this. Ooh, see, that's nice. I don't want, you need to go away probably. That I don't like that there. We can just replace this with dirt. This one should be okay. Let's actually replace, knock this away. Now that will be visible, I think, from over there. This flag. Now that's a pretty cool feature, and we can kind of something. See, we have fence for like that it's on, that's supporting it. So this is too big. Fence doesn't work vertically or horizontally, obviously. That's the dilemma. So, you know, we could do something like this and just call it good. And now this is one of those details where you kind of just have to use your imagination. Like, I feel like if somebody saw this, they'd get what it is. I don't know. Let me know what you think on that. I think that people would get what that is. Hello, phone. Hi. Right under the mic. That was probably really loud. The other thing that I don't like is that the netherrack is visible. But netherrack is part of this world. You could almost just say that they purposefully use it to light fire. Not so much like a cheap way for me to light a fire here. But it's actually part of the lore. Like, they collect it, they make a pit on top of this tower with it, and then they call it good. They don't really care what it looks like. I'm actually gonna cover this. Oh no. I'm gonna cover the bottom of this, just because if you walk in here, it's not like it's super detailed and like a whole lot to explore. But I don't want that to be visible. Much better. All right. So probably the last touch that I'm going to do off camera to this is a road. Now, a road all the way from this tower is going to be kind of tedious. It's really not going to take as long as I think it will or feel like it will. But it really, roads connect the world. I mean, I talked about it last episode. Roads just make people want to travel them. So use them. Just, if you got two structures, then put a road between them. It just makes everything feel so well connected. But yeah, let's just pretend that let's turn on shaders. Medium shaders? Yeah, because they got the shadows. Medium shaders are cool. And for the sake of it, let's change the time of day again to like the middle of the night. This would be like the equivalent of like 2 a.m. Like, or probably like 3 or 4 a.m. Because it's not too long from the... Oh, hello. Holy crap. That actually scared me. It's been so long since I've played at nighttime. Anyway, so just pretend that I'm a guard here, and And beautiful night. Nothing's gone wrong. I'm going to go back up to my post. Just doo-doo-doo on the way up. Pretend I'm a guard. Gonna go to bed. Take one last look around. Everything's good over there. The town is sleeping quietly. And down that way. Ah! One last thing that I'm gonna add to this tower, by the way, before we go, is this rim right here. Little roof line thing here. I have something very similar on this tower. I was just kind of looking at this, and wondering what I liked about it and why, you know, I felt like this was a little lacking. And then I added that, and I think it's much better now. So, yeah. Oh, man, I just woke up, and this is the view I got. This is beautiful. The town from here? Oh, this is going to, like, kill my frames, but I want to be able to see the windmill from here. Come on. There it is. Oh, that looks so cool. This is a great view. It really is. That windmill is such a, like, just, it's not, like, the craziest build. Like, the walls are flat oak. But, man, it just adds so much. This angle especially, it looks kind of ugly, actually. But the, like, aesthetic and thematic appeal of it is just, like, unbelievable. I love it. Can't really see anything through these, but ooh, you can see a little bit, enough that it catches your interest, especially with these shaders. That those houses are so bright. Oh, yeah. I love it. Yeah, no window down here to check. You can walk out. Look at this town. Too bad that we have a view of all these unfinished houses right here, the, like, four unfinished houses I need to do. Everything else looks great, though. I mean, you've got views all over. You've got the Farmers Guild over there. You've got the windmill down there. Bridge. Lighthouse, which needs to be done still. Wow, I can't believe there's still a dirt pillar on it. The only thing is that lighthouse is kind of ugly. I don't really know what I want to do with it. The pasture. By the way, the cow pasture video is one of my most viewed Let's Play videos. I guess, and it's because I consistently get, like, you know, a view here and there on it from people searching for Minecraft pastures or cow pastures. That and the pig pen, which is over here. You can't see it from here. Both get views. So, lesson you can learn from that. You can make, you know, let's build episode number 500 of building a fancy house. No one, that's not going to turn up in searches. Make stuff about, like, these unique things, and that will turn up in searches. But yeah, this is one of my favorite areas here. And now I really like, let's see what this looks like in the daytime. Let it render in. Oh, my frame rates. Yeah. Now we have this. I think you can tell that that's a flag there on the ground. Especially if you know what the flag here looks like. This is one of my favorite areas. I think making the road from here to there is just going to make that even better. But thank you for watching, everybody. Thank you for the 200 subscribers. It's awesome. I mean, you know, it's small. I get that. But, you know, after all this work, seeing that it's finally starting to pay off more and more, it's awesome to me. So thank you, everybody. See you next time. Bye.